this video, I'm going to tell you how the glucose leads to the insulin secretion from the beta cells of pancreas. Hey everyone, welcome back to HM Learnings. I'm Harshita, the creator of HM Learnings, where students come to clear their concept and to get the study material. Make sure that you have subscribed my channel. You can also follow HM Learnings on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter for daily updates. I have also started uploading all our slides on website known as SlideShare, so you can easily download and clip our slides from that website. So this is a very short video about how the insulin is secreted from the pancreatic cells, or you can say the beta cells of the pancreas, and what is the stimulus of that. So the most potent stimulus of the insulin secretion is basically the glucose. So now I'm telling you the steps that how it is going to stimulate or cause the release of the insulin. This is a beta cell of pancreas, and here on this membrane, we have a one transporter, and this transporter is called as a GLUT2. So this transporter is basically insulin independent, means it doesn't dependent on the insulin levels or in the blood. Okay, so to uptake what? To take the glucose. It is a transporter which is helping in the transport of glucose from outside to inside the beta cell, and its function doesn't depend upon the insulin level. Now after the glucose enters inside the cell, it will undergo metabolic pathways. So what are the metabolic pathways? It will undergo metabolism, and these metabolic pathways include like the glycolysis, the citric acid cycle, and by this what will produce? The ATP will be produced. Now this ATP will do what? It will actually close the ATP sensitive potassium channel. Now as this ATP sensitive potassium channel is closed because of the increase in the intracellular concentration of ATP, this will lead to the potassium accumulation inside the cell. So as there is potassium accumulation inside the cell, this leads to depolarization of the cell because of the decrease in the membrane potential negativity. So this will lead to what? This will lead to opening of a voltage dependent calcium channel, and there will be calcium influx. Okay, now what will happen because of this calcium influx? Already there are vesicles which contains the insulin are present in the beta cell of pancreas, and this calcium will trigger the exocytosis of these insulin in the circulation. So this is the whole mechanism that how it is happening. Now this slide is basically showing the same thing which I have explained to you. First, the glucose will be into the cell via the GLUT2 transporter, which is a facilitated diffusion. Then there will be increase in the glucose metabolism that is going to increase the ATP, and the ATP to ADP ratio will be get increased, as well as the NADH to NAD ratio will also be get increased. Now this will lead to the closure of the ATP sensitive potassium channel. There will be depolarization which will activate the voltage sensitive calcium channel, and hence there will be influx of the calcium channels which are leading to the release of this the exocytosis of this secretory granules. Okay, apart from this diagram also has shown that how the beta adrenergic stimulation is going to increase the insulin secretion, and that is by the help of the adrenal cyclase. So with this, we are done with this video. It is a very short video, and if you like this video, please like, share and comment it. Please let me know in the comment section any video you want me to do for you. Share our channel, subscribe our channel, and don't forget to check our slides on the SlideShare too. Till then, keep learning.